Musclemania was next. And the rock concert lights and stage only served to enhance what turned out to be a near national level bodybuilding event. Winning the 17 and under teenage class was Chris Barron, training partner of New Jersey star Vinny Galati. Although he's only been training for a year and a half, the Bay Own New Jersey resident has now racked up two class wins. Chris has a good frame to build on and will no doubt fill out and add size as he continues to train. Runner-up was Eric Krohn, who has also won several open men's division titles in his native Pennsylvania. Working as a forklift driver, he says his parents are very supportive, but that bodybuilding simply costs too much. Who couldn't relate to that statement? Coached by New York legend Mr. Universe Jerry Scalesi, teenage overall winner Joe Roboto had many in the audience shaking their heads in disbelief. The teenage Mr. USA had just turned 18, but had the thickness and muscle maturity rarely seen on anyone under the age of 30. It's almost impossible to comprehend, but this kid is just a high school senior. Unfortunately for a lot of teen bodybuilders, he weighed in at 205 pounds at 5'8". But next year, Scalesi plans on shocking the bodybuilding world with a 230-pound teenage sensation named Joe Roboto. Well, if you haven't been overwhelmed with muscle yet, stay tuned. Coming up next, the men's open class at the Philadelphia Musclemania. It really was the ultimate body battle. Stay with us. In only its second year, the Philadelphia Musclemania drew over 100 of the Northeast's toughest iron pumpers. It turned out to be close to national level quality in many weight classes, and the laser lights and video screens made it a show that won't soon be forgotten. While roaming the casinos of Atlantic City, you might see bantamweight winner Stephen Smith dealing cards with the same intensity he applies to his training. This makes his third title in 18 months of competitive bodybuilding. A Bay State bodybuilder coming up in the ranks is Derek Farnsworth. He's already accumulated wins at the Teenage New England, the NPC Massachusetts Lightweight Division, and the Gold Classic. Only 22 years old, Derek started training 5 years ago because his genetics seemed favorable for bodybuilding. He's also proud to say he's done it all 100% natural.
So I went to a couple of gyms, Gold's Gyms, World's Gyms, and I found a little gym called Sabine's Iron House in Fitchburg, which is all hardcore, and everybody wanted to teach everyone how to do it, so went there, trained for 3 years hard, got my first show, it was a natural show, never taken a drug, never will, my mother will kill me if I do.
Bodybuilding doesn't usually attract many college basketball players, but Antonio Lanz has found that building his body is even more fun than shooting hoops. In just 1 year of competing, the Mohammed Ben Aziza lookalike won the New Jersey Grand Prix overall, and his class at the Long Island Open. Leon Carman left Musclemania with his fourth lightweight win of the season, adding to victories at the Gasparty Classic, the Delaware State, and the Garden State. At age 36, this DuPont pipe fitter has been training for over two decades, even before the Beatles broke up. Oddly enough, he only began competing in 1990. Former AAU Teenage Mr. America Eric Spellman isn't just into muscles. He's also an aspiring songwriter set to record his first demo tape. His goal is to turn pro as a middleweight at next year's Nationals, and he thanks his daughter, Kasia Antoinette, for being his biggest fan. Kenneth Milanek trekked all the way from Warren, Michigan to get on the Musclemania stage and was rewarded with a runner-up spot in this tough middleweight class. The dietetic student at Wayne State University began training in high school to improve his hockey playing. His physique quickly blossomed, and he decided to chuck the hockey stick and propel into bodybuilding.
I guess the main reason I was attracted to bodybuilding was because I started to see results, and I thought I could do well. It's just like anything, if you don't think you're going to do well in it, it sort of scares you away from it, but I started to see real good results, so I continued with it.
Weights have only been a part of middleweight winner Frankie Prather's life for 3 years. But he's already won the Maryland State teenage title in bodybuilding and another in powerlifting. His entire family made the trip from Maryland to see him compete in Philadelphia. And in preparation for Musclemania, Frankie found that killer weights weren't necessary to hold on to muscle size in the last weeks of dieting.
For this show, my training basically stayed heavy for the beginning part of my diet, which was 12 weeks. Then as I dropped calories and started to lose a little bit of energy, I dropped the weights, but I kept the intensity level up and just kicked in a lot of extra aerobics to burn off all the fat.
The lightweight class was brutal, with almost 20 competitors. In fifth was Milton Holloway, Jr., a chemical operator from Wilmington, Delaware. At 25 years old, he's already been training 11 years, under the watchful eye of noted Philadelphia trainer, Dr. Richard Brown. Fourth place went to Tom Reffel, a chemist from Southampton, Pennsylvania. His plan for success in bodybuilding is centered around heavy weights and lots of food.
For this show, I was able to eat a lot more. I increased my metabolism a lot over the off season, and then I was able to eat up to 5,000-6,000 calories a few weeks out of the show, and ate right in through the show, got my weight right at 198 pounds. So it was a lot easier this year, a lot more full and a lot more muscle.
Former Mr. Pennsylvania Brian Daskam made an impressive appearance and took third. This entrepreneur holds a master's degree and pioneered a fitness and nutrition program for the GNC vitamin stores called Fit Systems. Brian began training 12 years ago to develop size, strength, and self-esteem. Now it mandates his livelihood. A gym owner for 10 years, runner-up Tim Dime has scored previous victories at the NPC Pennsylvania and Lehigh Valley contests and placed fourth at the IFBB North American. But Tim told us it's his wife and family during his 7 years of competing that helped make his wins possible. Blowing away this nightmarish light heavyweight division was Dave "Da Beef" Brown. Incredibly muscular at 5'5 and 196 pounds, he's been in the U.S. Army over 10 years and has won titles such as the Armed Forces, Mr. Los Angeles, and the Mr. Germany. He also has been successful at powerlifting, which explains his tremendous muscle density. Unlike many competitors, Dave genuinely has a good time on stage. After all, they do call him the Singing Marine. So if the light heavyweights weren't impressive enough, check out fifth in the heavyweights and one of Pennsylvania's most popular competitors, Big Joe Layton. He began training 7 years ago just to lose body fat, but soon began to like the way his muscles were taking shape and growing. This nuclear power maintenance engineer follows Canadian Dave Fisher's regimen. Off-season calls for heavyweights and heavy food, while pre-contest is heavyweights and no food. Even with such a determined attitude, Joe keeps a pragmatic perspective on bodybuilding.
Today you got to really be realistic about bodybuilding because the guys are getting so good. I mean, every year somebody's getting bigger and harder. But I want to be a professional bad, and I'll keep competing until I am a professional. But realistically, I enjoy it, and if I never become a professional, I'll be happy where I'm at.
Another former college basketball star was fourth place Dennis Berry, who's so big that his nickname in the Bronx, New York is the D-Train. Following the guidance of Joe Perillo, he's brought his off-season weight to a muscular 280 pounds in only 6 years of training. The 25-year-old personal trainer was the overall winner of the Metropolitan Championships in New York City. In third was former wrestler and teenage Pennsylvania bodybuilding champion Phil Wilmore. Thickly developed at 5'9 and 215, the 21-year-old credits his heavy training right up to the contest for his ability to hold muscle size while dieting. Runner-up Chris Aceto certainly needs no introduction to our viewers. Although he hasn't won a bodybuilding contest since the 89 Collegiate Nationals, his fame as a nutritionist and diet guru to many of the top amateurs and professionals is already legendary. Of recent, Chris is responsible for North American champion Paul Dillett's big win. Together with his wife, professional bodybuilder Laura Crevel, he makes up half of America's fittest couple. And recently, they authored a cookbook called The Light Lifestyle. This was Chris's first contest appearance as a heavyweight, but certainly not his last. However, another man also moved up to the heavyweight class, the genetically gifted Steve McLeod. He'd already won the Niagara Falls Grand Prix and the Castilian Championships while spending a semester in Spain. His tiny joints and superb bone structure mean that every bit of muscle Steve gains only adds to his overall symmetry and creates the illusion of a much heavier man. It isn't just his body that makes Steve genetically gifted. He also has a metabolism that most bodybuilders would die for.
Well, aerobics, no, I didn't really do not too much aerobics until it was about 8 weeks out from the show. And to be perfectly honest with you, my calories were high, but a lot of that is owed to McDonald's. I mean, going twice a day to McDonald's, I know. That's not too good, but that was part of my diet. I have a fast metabolism, so my body metabolizes it pretty well.
It was with great anticipation that muscle maniacs wondered whether light heavy Brown or heavyweight McLeod would walk away with the overall Muscle Mania title. But when the smoke cleared and the NPC judges had made their decision, it was light heavy David Brown who stood victorious as the Philadelphia Muscle Mania champion. American Sports Network would like to thank the competitors and those in the audience who once again made the Philadelphia Fitness Festival the crowning moment of the 1992 summer tour and the most exciting amateur bodybuilding event in bodybuilding. For Muscle Magazine, I'm Chris Adams.